Hello, my name is Iana Komarnytska, and in this video we are going to talk about belly dancing in restaurants. And first I'm going to share some of the reasons why I think it can be a good idea for belly dancers who are thinking about developing their solo dance career to try to work in restaurants. And then right after that, I will give you some tips on how you can get into the restaurant gigs world. But I also want to bring your attention that if you're interested in performing in restaurants as a belly dance job, you're probably also interested in performing at other events such as weddings or birthday parties or corporate events. And in order to achieve all these and to enter professional belly dance world in your local area, one of the helpful tools can be the business course for belly dancers, where I put together all my knowledge on belly dance gigs, starting from how to get involved into it, how to communicate with clients, how to structure your program, which is different from performing at students' hafla or belly dance festivals, and finishing on how to develop and put together a long-lasting, successful solo dance career. So the link to this course is also in the description to this video, so go ahead and click it and open in a new tab so that you don't forget to check the entire course right after you finish watching this video, because something tells me it can be a very good and helpful tool for you. On this note, let's dive into the world of restaurant gigs. Another important topic that I want to talk about is specifically working in restaurants. And I know there is a lot of resistance among dancers very often, especially those dancers who are more trained and groomed in belly dance festival world, and then they want to enter the commercial world of local gigs. But there is some resistance about thinking specific about restaurant work, because it's like less prestige, or it's beyond, it defeats the worth of art. There is a lot of that resistance too. But here are a couple of very important reasons for you to think why it's actually a good idea to have experience working in the restaurant. And there are two sections along with some practical points of how I approached the work in restaurants, because I actually, when I started working at local gigs, I had that resistance too, and I was like, I would never work in the restaurants. That was my original like thought and mindset. And then with time it changed quite a few, because looking at what is happening in general in the belly dance world and our connection with a general audience, with time I realized and I started approaching it as on like a high level, like not practical things, but more like generic, let's say, mindset things, as restaurants is actually one of the most efficient and direct ways for us as belly dancers to popularize our dance form among general audience. Because people, regular people who have no connection to belly dance, they probably, when they decide where to go on the weekend, they will not think like, oh, is there any belly dance concert? Let me check. No, they probably will go to a bunch of other concerts, events, ballet shows, whatever other like performances or entertainment, but belly dance show, belly dance concert, it's not gonna be on their mind like as an option, like let me check if there's anything going on in the city or any belly dance hafla. No, typical for those events, we have our audience as other belly dancers or their friends and relatives, but those people are already directly or indirectly involved in the belly dance world. That's not a general audience who does not have any understanding or connection to belly dance. At the same time, they may think like, oh, let's go to this restaurant, like Arabic inspired or Moroccan themed restaurant. Doesn't even need to be Arabic restaurant, but can be Arabic in sense that its owner is from Middle East and they are focusing their audience among Middle East community, local Middle Eastern community. I'm talking even about regular restaurant that has a Moroccan theme. That can be on the mind for many people as a way to connect with their friends and to have something different and special. Oh, let's go to that Moroccan restaurant to try the cuisine. And oh, by the way, they have a show. So in this case, this is the closest and most frequent connection of regular audience with ballet dance art. And I always get sad whenever professional dancers kind of state that restaurants is not worth, you should not dance there. I always get sad because imagine that all professional dancers leave the restaurant industry and the field of ballet dance. Then who will be left there? Owners of the restaurant, they still will find someone to perform, but is it going to be a ballet dance really? Or is it going to be some kind of show that will only enforce all those stereotypes and all those misinterpretations that general audience already have about this art form? So for me, I always consider that it's a great chance for me as a dancer, whom I perceive myself a professional dancer, who trained for many years and know the culture and the background of the dance and history of the dance and nuances of the dance. It's a great chance for me to be that introduction for someone to the world of ballet dance, or even change the perception and idea about ballet dance for general audience. Restaurants is the one of the most easiest and direct ways for us to connect ballet dancers and general audience. And to be honest, in terms of artistic fulfillment, there is nothing better and more fulfilling and inspiring that someone comes after your show and says, oh my God, I did not expect that ballet dance can be like this. I never imagined that it can be so artistic and can be so entertaining, and entertaining in a good way. Like, people will use different words, but the idea is that you change their understanding of what is ballet dance. And for me, restaurants, it was a way of popularizing this art for one general audience. But this is more about mindset, and maybe something now clicked for you too, like taking responsibility for spreading awareness about what is really the art of ballet dance using the restaurant gigs. But more on a practical part, there is a couple things for you as a solo performer why I strongly recommend to at least consider performing in the restaurants. If not always, but at least a certain period of your dance career. First of all, of course, it's a cash flow. Yes, the restaurant gigs will be paid less than one-time bookings for weddings or private parties or corporate events, because you are booked on a regular basis. So whenever you start working in the restaurant, the payment per each separate show is lower than other gigs, but you have certainty or guarantee that you actually will be hired. You will have a job like once in a week, or even if it's once in a month, it's still regular. It's 12 gigs through one client, the restaurant owner, throughout the year that you know you will have. And often it can be even several times per week. Depends on your city and what restaurants exist and what they have, how frequent shows they host and how much audience and visitors they have, of course. But it's a, you have maybe lower payment per show, but you have a guarantee that it's a reoccurring show. So, and you're not, again, negotiating, you're not trying to find any extra. It's already established. You talked once to the restaurant owner or manager, and it's set up for reoccurring period of time. So cash flow, it's one of the reasons why I think you should consider doing restaurant gigs. Second, it's actually a channel through which clients can find you and book for their one-time events. But here I want you to understand a very thin but very specific difference. Restaurant events, restaurant performances, it's not a showcase events for you. So if you ever in your negotiation process with any restaurant owner, you hear like, oh, come perform at our restaurant for this much, because it's such a great showcase opportunity for you. No, that's not the case. It's just the same showcase opportunity for you, just as performing at someone's wedding or performing at someone's birthday. This is not a showcase event. We will talk about specifically what is showcase events for you, for which you can either lower your price or even perform for free, and it will benefit only you because if it's a showcase event. Restaurant performance is just the same performance for you as any other from showcasing point of view. Yes, there is a chance that someone will see you and hire you, but it's not like the whole room is consists of event organizers or the whole room is future brides and grooms who are looking for entertainment for their wedding. No, it's a regular random audience, and the chance that is someone who will hire you, it's a matter of luck, basically. There is no guarantee. So never take that as an excuse to lower like your price in terms of negotiating prices with restaurant managers or like pricing to perform there. No, it's not a showcase event. But you also need to understand that you have a little benefit in terms of showcasing and those chances, lucky chances that someone will actually hire you from restaurant, because first it's a more frequent performances and bigger rotation of people. Plus it's people who come to the restaurant with the idea like, oh, I'm interested in at least checking this Moroccan theme. What's that? They at the restaurant, maybe with a couple of their friends, they saw ballet dancers and, oh, we have upcoming birthday party. Can you come and perform to us? So it's bigger rotation flow of the people, and more frequent performances can give you, they can increase the number of those lucky chances for you. And also there's a little less resistance in terms like, oh, I don't want to repeat someone else's idea. For instance, if you're performing at a wedding, in general, you have just the same chances that someone will think, oh, I like this performance, I want to bring it to my event too. Just the same as in restaurant. But with wedding, it can be also like other psychological reasons for person like, oh, maybe it's a relative. And then it's like, oh, but half of my guests will be the same as at this wedding, and I don't want them to think that I just repeat and copy someone's idea. So there can be that kind of resistance. Typically, it's very low, so it's not going to be like the factor that person like, no, I will not hire, as generally saying, but it can be another factor in their decision to hire or not to hire a ballet dancer, because they kind of feel like, oh, I don't want to copy. I want something else. I want to surprise. That's like those weddings, birthday parties, etc. Then they see you at someone else's event. With restaurants, there is no such psychological resistance, because they come just as a night out, maybe a couple friends they will see, but there is no pressure like, oh, I'm not copying someone's event because it's a restaurant event. Like, there is no one to copy unless they are future restaurant owners and they want to open their own restaurant. But it's more like one in a million chances that something will happen there. And maybe they will like your show so much that they will want to invite you for even a higher pay or something like that. But generally speaking, I think you got this idea. It's not for negotiating for you in your talk with restaurant owner, but this is for you to understand another benefit as an add-on benefit of actually working in the restaurant. Another reason is that restaurants will give you invaluable, unbelievable experience of dealing with so many different people as the audience participants. Good and bad, doesn't matter. It's more like about experience, because on your gigs, you will always have some trouble situations that you will need to know how to troubleshoot them on spot. And if you're performing at someone's wedding, there is much more pressure on you to hold, to navigate the situation nicely and promptly than in the restaurant setting. it's usually much more relaxed because the audience, even members, it's not them hiring you directly. They just come to the restaurant and also they see your show. But it's an invaluable experience of how to navigate different situations, how to practice your program. It's also a practice space, I call it, although you do want to have a good show every time, regardless of the event, of the kind of event. But sometimes we get new ideas and we think like, oh, I don't know if it will work or not. I think it would be cool. Restaurants, it's one of the coolest, safest place for you to experiment with your own program and see what works and what not works. And you can do it several times and you will see reaction of very different people who came to the restaurant with a very different mindset. And you can see what works for whom and analyze and then better structure your program in general. But it's a space for you to experiment and space for you to get this invaluable experience of feeling connection to the audience and dealing with different kind of audience. Because some of the people, they came and they really engaged in your show, okay, and it's one way how to you can involve them, how you can make them participate in your show. And it's very different said that someone come, they just want to eat and talk to their friends, they don't care about your show. But maybe they are right in the middle, so you cannot really avoid them. How you deal in this situation with the resistance of the audience. And this experience you will bring to your events too. Because sometimes you go to one party and everyone is like wants to dance and wants to participate. Great. And some events you go, it's maybe a corporate event and everyone is angry on their boss for whatever reason. Or they feel very formal. They want just like... they're very close. Okay, this is very not warming audience. It may nothing to do with you, but you got in that environment and you have this cold audience who does not react anyway to your show. How you deal with that? All that experience you can gain way faster through working in the restaurants as well as experimenting with your own program and see what works and what not works. You have much more freedom in the restaurants to do it. And another very important reason why to work with restaurant, it's another benefit that can be, you actually can create your portfolio material through the restaurant work. You can always talk to manager or restaurant owner if maybe one day some of your friend photographer can come and take a couple of pictures or videos. Sometimes they need this kind of material for their own promotions. We can always collaborate, like, okay, let me help you organize. Maybe I know some photographer who can come and do it, but I will use it also for myself. And you can also use it for whatever promotion you need. Always in this case, negotiate first with the restaurant owner. Just don't bring just by surprise, official photographer and nobody expected him and the audience or the restaurant visitors there like wondering like what is going on. Like, no, all these nuances has to be talked with the restaurant owner and managed. But at the same time, nobody can stop you from just inviting your friend who can come and just take their phone and record a little bit part of your show, just the same way as any other visitors in the restaurant will be doing it, because everyone will be doing it. And remember a little trick how to find a content like photo and video content from social media. Don't forget, if you're working on a regular basis or even after one gig, regular gig at restaurants, don't forget a few days after, go on social media, check the tags or locations tagged by this specific place and see if someone, anyone recorded and put anything online. Maybe there will be some cute photo or cute short video clip. That's again your promotional material that you can use if it's a decent quality and you like what you saw there. But that's another chance, especially if you don't have any portfolio or any strong portfolio, you can use a restaurant work there. And if you're working on a regular basis, typically you already have established a nice relationship with owner, and maybe don't start right from your first gig saying like, oh, can I bring my photographer? But with time, once you feel like you become like in a good relationship and there is a trust and there is a friendly environment for that, like, just go ahead and ask, oh, can I use this space and this shows to do a little clips of me dancing, performing, so both you and restaurant can have some extra promotional material. In terms of how to get in the restaurant gigs, I also already talked about this, but you always need to figure out. First, you need to find out with restaurant, do they have a belly dance show or not? Because if they don't have a belly dance show, you can just reach out and suggest an offer. If their theme matches the idea of having a belly dancer, why not just to go and ask, oh, do you want to add belly dance show to your program? Let's figure out how can we make it happen. And you negotiate this on your terms, but also making sure that it's beneficial not only to you, but also to the restaurant owner, and you negotiate the possible program. If the restaurant already has active belly dance shows, first thing you need to figure out, is it one dancer working there on a regular basis? Or is it a rotation of dancers? If it's one dancer, you go and contact that dancer, again, establish a nice relationship, and basically offering, if she ever needs a substitute dancer, you would be happy to help with that. So you're showing that you're not trying to take over her job behind her back, but you are respecting that she put time and energy to get that gig and she's working there, and it's basically part of her job too and her income too. So always be respectful to that, but you can always establish nice relationship, and who knows, there can be a very quickly comes the situations that she will be inviting you to sub, or maybe it will never come, or maybe it will come just in the future somehow, and that dancer may just remember about you, and maybe she already left the restaurant, but for some other occasion she will remember specifically you and involve you into something. But if it's one restaurant or one performer at the restaurant on a regular basis, always first of all get in contact with her. Don't do things behind her back. Another situation, if it's a rotation of dancers, so probably in this case, you actually need to find out who is responsible for organizing and scheduling dancers. It can be directly restaurant owner, it can be restaurant manager, and it can be one of the dancers, like a lead dancer who maybe she originally started just on her own in the restaurant, but then she started involving other dancers. And then it happened that she is actually putting everyone together, scheduling, doing all these decisions, who will perform, when, etc. So in this case, you're contacting person who is responsible for a rotation of dancers. And again, you're offering like, oh, I would love to work in this restaurant. If they're not ready to accept or not willing to accept you right away, again, that's totally fine. That's their decision, and you are entering their established world already. But nothing stops you, or there will be no harm, still offer like, okay, still, here are my contacts. If you ever need a sub dancer that you can't find anyone, I will be really happy to assist specifically in those situations. But you never know in advance. Maybe you will show up specifically in a perfect time that they are right now looking for extra dancers, and they will be just absolutely happy to include you in their rotation because it actually, they have a shortage of dance performers. You never know what you don't know, and you will find out only after you actually reach and ask them and reach out for to create those opportunities for yourself to have extra performances, not only on a regular basis, but even establishing relationships with people who can refer you to other gigs that are not restaurant gigs, but maybe a restaurant owner was requested, someone was organizing a banquet, wedding banquet party at their event, at their venue, and they want to have a belly dance performer, and restaurant owner will know about you, so they may refer you to them, even if they maybe don't have a regular belly dance show in their restaurant, like on a weekly or daily basis. Just the same as audience members who may see you, just the same as dancers with whom you established a relationship, they also may at some point in the future refer some gig to you. So restaurant, it's cash flow, but it's also the channel through which you actually can have extra, like more gigs for you as a solo dance performer.
Don't forget to like this video, comment what takeaways you had from it, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. As well as don't forget to check the entire business course for ballet dancers with over 100 lectures, just like the one you saw right now, and 34 hours of content, everything about ballet dance geek. Good luck with your professional dance journey.